By the end of this video, you'll have a list of all the latest trendy tools that you can use to help you in your role as a Scrum Master. But first, let's start with a question that I recently got via email from one of my coaching clients, Jane. I am currently training in Agile and one day hope to be a qualified Scrum Master. I am really enjoying your videos. However, I would like some advice, particularly when it comes to the tools used during a Scrum meeting. I would greatly appreciate any advice. How do you go about recording your notes during the daily Scrum? What tools or apps do you use for this? What are the best practices? I am currently using OneNote, but I feel totally unorganized and overwhelmed. First off, let's agree on something together. The tools are not important. It's the outcome that's important. What you're trying to do, what you're trying to achieve with these tools. Asking for a list of tools to use is a very broad question. As a Scrum Master, you're here to support the team, to help the team. So start with the outcome in mind. What are we trying to achieve? What are the issues, problems of the team? What are they struggling with? What do they want to improve? What do they want to do? What are their goals? The outcomes. And once you have all these things, you find some tools or practices or processes to help you achieve or attain these outcomes together as a team. And when I read your email, it seems that you're doing that. I give you that. You're doing that. You're starting with the outcome, taking notes during the daily Scrum, and you're looking for a tool to achieve this outcome. But the problem is that the outcome is wrong. Why are you even joining the daily Scrum? You know that you're optional in the daily Scrum, right? The daily Scrum is for the developers, by the developers. It's their meeting so that they can craft a plan how to work together for the day. You can join as a Scrum Master, but you're not required to. The only thing that you're required to, if you read the Scrum Guide 2020, is to ensure that the meeting is being held every single day and is time boxed to 15 minutes. And even more, you're taking notes during the daily Scrum. Literally taking notes during the daily Scrum. Why? What are you even doing with these notes? What are in these notes? Like what people do every day? What are you doing with that? Are you using that to micromanage people during the day? Ensure that they do what they said they would do? You try to compare these notes with what they say in the next session, in tomorrow's daily Scrum? Why are you doing that? Do you don't trust them? Without context, I really can't help you, but it seems that there are some anti-patterns that you're following here. So fix that first. Your outcome for the daily Scrum is to ensure that it's done every single day and that it's time boxed to 15 minutes. How do you do that? Are there tools that allow you to do that? Yes, there are. Obviously, you need a tool to do the meeting. If it's online, if it's on site, maybe a whiteboard, a Scrum, physical Scrum board. There's quite a few things that you can use. I suggest watching this video right here where I go through what I use to facilitate the daily Scrum compared to the three questions, what I did yesterday, what will I do today, any blockers. I don't like that. Now let's go back to the tools that you can actually use as a Scrum Master to support you. Let's break down your work, the Scrum Master role, into a few categories. First, planning, estimation. You help the team do that, so you need a tool to do that. Tracking your work, metrics, reports, facilitating sessions, Scrum events, the daily Scrum, or any other session, and communicating. How are you talking to each other? Email, instant messaging, different categories, different tools for all these. But I still need to mention, before going into the tools, remember the Agile value, people and interactions over processes and tools. No matter what you do as a Scrum Master, you need to ensure or help the team prioritize these people and interactions. We have a tendency to prioritize the use of, you need to follow this process, you need to use this tool, especially with Jira. What about people and interactions? Always have this in mind, because if you don't, no one is having that in mind. I guarantee you that, because we are focused in following the tools and processes. At least you, as a Scrum Master, you can preach, how are we ensuring to prioritize people and interactions? Just ask questions. Don't need to tell them what to do. Just simply ask questions. Let's start with facilitation and an event that Scrum Master generally facilitate every single sprint, the sprint retrospective. I use a simple tool to do that. Easy Retro. I know people that use Miro also to do that, but I use Easy Retro. Extremely simple, like the name Easy Retro. You can see it on the screen right now, and the link is down below. I sometimes also do a lean coffee retro style. I use leancoffee.org to do that. What I like about the lean coffee is that basically everyone inputs their ideas. It can be anything. It doesn't need to be what needs to improve, what went well and all that. It can be anything. And we vote on these ideas. And then the timer starts, we have 5 minutes to talk about these ideas. And after 5 minutes, the application gives us the opportunity to either vote on continuing the discussion, ending the discussion, or neutral. So basically everyone is deciding, should we end or not? The application is basically facilitating the discussion for you. I really like that. Next is the tracking tool. Most companies I work with use Jira and Confluence to store their documents. If you want a lighter free version, you can use Trello, ClickUp. There's so many tools that you can use to track your work, and tools that allow you to create sprints. Use the Scrum framework. Yeah, there's many tools that allow you to do that, not only Jira. For communication, email, Outlook. Most companies use that. Microsoft Teams, Slack, Zoom. But again, why are you focusing on that? If you're a Scrum Master, I'm sure that's not your role to implement these types of applications. When you join a company, all these things are already there. So just use these tools. Use these effectively, efficiently. But I wouldn't even think about these tools. Just use what the company has as tools. For facilitating the daily Scrum, I usually let the developers facilitate the daily Scrum, and I like using the walk the board method. You can watch this video for more details on how to do that. So you don't need any application or any special application here. You just open your board, either physical board at the office, you watch the board, you look at the board, and you walk through the board, or you can use Jira if it's a digital board that you're using. Now, that's for synchronous daily Scrum. But what about asynchronous daily Scrums? If you don't want to do meetings, you want to asynchronously communicate during the day. Asynchronous communication is basically messaging. Someone sends you a message, you don't need to reply online. You can reply after 1 hour or even after 1 day. You can use the same method for the daily Scrum, an application called Geek. But again, link down below. Basically a bot that you can link to your communicating application like Slack, Microsoft Teams, that prompts you every single day, every member of the team at a certain time during the day. It's time to do the daily Scrum. What did you do yesterday? And you reply personal private message with a bot. And then the bot combines everything together and posts it in the general channel so that everyone can see. And we can communicate via the bot, raise impediments via the bot. Yeah, I would like it. I like using this application. And for me, asynchronous communication, that's the future. For facilitating workshops, brainstorming sessions, creative mind mapping sessions, I use Miro. The Miro application can literally do anything. There's templates that people build, and you can use multiple templates to literally do anything. You can do the daily Scrum using Miro. You can use sprint retrospectives, brainstorming sessions, anything you can think of that forms part of these agile practices, processes, are in Miro. It's free to use. There are some limitations, but if you want to invest, forget about any other application. Use Miro. Again, the link is down below. Now, very important, how do you track, plan, estimate your work? How are you ensuring that you're productive during the day, efficient, effective during the day? Are you using Miro to brainstorm your ideas? Are you using Jira to track your work? That's something that's often overlooked when talking about these kinds of tools for Scrum Masters. We talk about tools that Scrum Masters can use to help the team. That's not the only thing that we need to talk about. The most important thing here is, how are you being effective or efficient yourself? How are you tracking your work? Because you can't really help the team if you're not helping yourself first. And again, even for your work, talking about tools that can help you is too broad. What are you trying to achieve? Track your work, store your documents, be creative. All these things, I use a single tool. A single tool to do all these things. Personal life, my work, my consulting business, an application called Notion. And I use a system called Second Brain, created by Thiago Forte. And the idea behind this system is, your brain is here to generate ideas, not store them. So all my documents in this application, my to-do list, my projects, all the things that I need to do in this application, my reminders in this application. So I just wake up every day and the application tells me what to do, helps me generate creative ideas, writing this script, doing this video, I used this application. To get ideas for this video, I used this application. To know what to do, the steps required to film this video, I use this application. And same thing for the role of a Scrum Master. I track all my meetings, all the notes of my meetings, each individual member of the team folders for them. When was our last one-to-one session? What are the strengths and weaknesses of this person? What am I currently doing to help them and for the team? What are the stats of the team? Their agile maturity levels, their pain points. Everything is tracked into this application. I'm sure as a Scrum Master, you're already doing that, but maybe the data is scattered everywhere. Use the Notion app. It's totally free. Which brings me to my next point. If you want more tips, insights on Agile Scrum personal growth, click on the video that stands out the most on the screen right now, and I'll see you in a few seconds.